A culturally safe space is one in which a person feels equal and valued, and their culture is acknowledged and respected. For our mob, it means a place where there is no denial of our identity, challenge to our history, or assault on our culture.
Our mob's culture is strong, and football is woven into it. It's in our blood. It binds our communities, so it's vital footy is a safe cultural space.
The ovals, the club rooms and the stands must be places where people come together for the love of the game, what each player brings to the team and what each connected family brings to the club. Football clubs, if done right, become places of belonging. A football club family.
There's a bloody good reason so many of our mobs shine when our culture is celebrated. Ask Eddie Betts, who kicked goal of the year twice in Sir Doug Nicholls' round. Doesn't take a genius to work out that if we feel equal and valued, we can perform at our peak.
Just like Lance Franklin, who has the whole football world willing him to 1,000 goals. Just 20 to go, buddy.
Good things happen in safe cultural spaces. Empowerment flows from being able to safely represent who you are and where you come from.
There is no doubt we would have more Indigenous players in the league if racism wasn't so prevalent.
Imagine the league we would have, the players we would see. From personal experience, when I was at Swan Districts in Perth, it was one of the happiest times of my life. Why? Because I was accepted for who I was and made to feel so welcome. The byproduct was that I had a clear mind for the first time in a long time, and I was able just to focus on footy. That's what happens when you feel valued and included.
Building safe cultural spaces starts with being accepting of someone's differences.
It only takes a split second to make someone feel unwelcome, and a split second for someone to put it right. By standing up, showing support and stamping out racism when they see it or hear it, straight up.
Because every time racism rears its ugly head, the game risks losing someone. If you can't feel safe whilst playing the game, quite simply, you'll stop playing, and the game will lose its exhilarating Indigenous essence and unique brand of play.
That's how we lost Goodsy. I wonder who else we lost along the way. I wonder how many brilliant juniors were forced to turn their backs on a space that didn't accept them, and in some cases, turn them into someone else they didn't want to be.
The players and the league are making great gains in building safe spaces. The peak rule is a significant part of that, especially because it protects players at local levels too.
Though we all have a part to play, at under 12s, at local games, or in the outer at the G, if you see it, hear it, or read it online, call it out. Because there's only one way to build a truly safe cultural space, and that's together.
The rewards are everyone's to share.
This is Yokayi Footy.